industry. Pradeep Mehta is somebody I turn to now. I met him in 1992 with a jhola and kolapuri chappal in Geneva when I was first secretary GATT and he walked into my office. The reason I caricature him somewhat is because, Pradeep, I'll be honest, the one thing that never figures in Indian trade debate is consumers' interest. People are all the time talking of lobbies. People talk of producers. People talk of Indian industry facing job losses. Tell me one time when somebody has said, can the Indian consumer benefit with extra choice or not? But this I'm partly provoking you because of your background.
Thank you. In fact, first of all, let me thank Sameer Kocher and the SKOCH Foundation for this. And those of you who are not here at 9 o'clock in the morning, I was surprised to see the convening power of SKOCH Foundation that we had a huge crowd in the morning. And that was, you know, I mean, all of us were surprised. There were many of us who were talking on the side. That is to be taken out from my time so that I can come to the, I thought, you know, some of you are not there in the morning, so it's good to.
Over the weekend.
Over the weekend, on a Saturday morning. Now, having said that, I think Mohan has asked me a very pertinent question, and there is a book which is a part of this particular list first session. It's a festive on me and when I turned 70. Mohan has also contributed an excellent essay in that. It's called Putting Consumers First, and that is what we've been talking about since we began, that we often tend to ignore the consumer interest. And I can, you know, the time being very little, I can't get into anecdotes, but just to say that consumers are very important to consider in any public policy making and not just trade policy. Now, answering a question about competitiveness, this is an area that we are working on. In fact, we're looking at 4 labor-intensive sectors, doing a very thorough empirical research to find out as to, you know, what is happening or what is not happening, what are the pain points and how should we resolve them. There's the textiles and garments, food processing, tourism, and then we are getting into construction of one more sector. Now, that will give us a fairly good understanding as to how do we, you know, impact the competitiveness. This is not something which was said in the morning also, and something which I would like to refer to what Sachin said was, now, we do not have a convergence between our trade policy and industrial policy and competition policy. These are 3 important pillars of any economic governance, which is what, now, at a macro level, there is. But at a micro level, when you look at various sectors, you'll find there is, you know, it is missing. Like, you know, you get results like inverted duty structure, for example. I'm just giving one example. Sorry, I'm going to rush this because of very limited time. It's a very complex and a very large subject to deal with easily. The problem of improving our competitiveness, another problem that we have, is that we are a federation. We are a quasi-federal country, but we are a federation of various states. And each state has to set a target to meet with our $5 trillion economy. UP has already taken the lead. Yogi Adityanath said that, you know, we'll aim at $1 trillion. And that's that. If UP can do $1 trillion in the next 5 years, then the others can do. So what we have also spoken about is fragmenting these targets, you know, across various states, depending on the sizes, et cetera, et cetera. Then when it comes to nuts and bolts, and that is where the problems are, ease of doing business. We heard Amitabh Kant speak about ease of doing business, et cetera, et cetera. We are writing a paper on ease of running a business. You know, you heard about that tax terrorism, V.G. Siddharth of Cafe Coffee Day suiciding, and that is a story which I hear from many businessmen friends of mine. They are not suiciding, thanks God. But the fact is that Siddharth really did shake up, and when, you know, Prime Minister came out with a statement that we have to respect our wealth creators. Now, if that kind of statement then sort of boils down across the nation, in spite of the fragmented polity that we have, and which is getting more and more fragmented, we do not have that kind of, how is it that, you know, something which has not been addressed since the morning is that how do you deal with many of these issues without a social stability? We do not have social stability as we stand today. Let us be frank and candid about these things. Nobody has spoken about it. They're all afraid. there is social instability today. And how do you deal with this, including in the kind of political issues which come up? Let me go back to WTO in the sense that when you talk about, there are external factors which do help us to improve our competitiveness. Mind you, we liberalized our tariffs voluntarily in 1990s. There was no external pressure. And in fact, there was even a question asked, and look, why did you not cash your check? Forget it, we wanted to liberalize ourselves. We brought down our average tariffs to 14% from somewhere. So that time there was no external pressure. That was a decision that we, a considered decision that we had. China, if those of you may not know, has never been a member of the WTO, founding member. India has been a founding member. China struggled a lot to get into the WTO and got into in Doha ministerial meeting. This is in 2001. Now, Chinese policymakers said very clearly, we are getting into the WTO to lock our domestic reforms. Let's not forget, when you have these external pressures, then you do lock in. Now, if we had not, I'm looking at TRIPS, you know, without getting into merits to demerits. If we had not entered into TRIPS, we would not have been able to improve our innovation. The kind of patenting which is already happening. And a lot of these things are not spoken about very clearly, but RIS is doing a lot of work on that. They have covered a lot of these areas. So the kind of progress which has taken place in terms of patenting, which is so important, we would not have done it. We would have continued to do process patenting and reverse engineering and be happy that, you know, we built the biggest pharmaceutical industry in the world. So we have competitive sectors that we need to look at, but the point is very simple, that it has to be disaggregated, you know, and chopped up into various segments, like what I said, including, you know, every province being given, say, look, what is it that you are going to do in the next 5 years from this $5 trillion basket? How much are you going to contribute? Yogi Adityanath is ready to contribute by 12. So in order to do all that, then you have to ensure that your entrepreneurs' animal spirits are let loose. And don't forget that it is inherently there. We have Indians are inherently entrepreneurship. And that is historical, if you look at our centuries of history.